everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. Have you ever wanted the effects environment to start up in a certain way? Perhaps always start with a certain timeline effects, or perhaps you have a particular setup you'd like to use when starting a new image, action, or Gmask Tracer timeline effects. Using Flame 2022, this is now possible. So in this video, you'll learn how to set up the default timeline effects for the effects environment, as well as customize the default settings for the image, action, and Gmask Tracer timeline effects. Now, when you start working with the effects environment, it has a couple of default behaviors when you start using it. Firstly, if you go to a segment in your sequence and just switch to the effects environment without adding timeline effects, Flame automatically uses image as the chosen timeline effects. If you switch to other shots in the storyboard reel, Flame will use the current timeline effects, which in this case is image. If this had been another timeline effects, like 2D Transform for example, switching between different shots would load the last current timeline effects, which is 2D Transform. So hopefully you get the gist of these expected behaviors. Now I'm going to remove all the timeline effects and return to the sequence. To change the default behavior of the effects environment, open the Flame main menu and choose the Preferences, Tools, Timeline Effects. Here you will find a setting called Default Timeline Effects. With the option set to Current Timeline Effects, Flame will use the image timeline effects by default, and it will load the last current timeline effects as you switch between shots in the storyboard reel. If you click the pull-down menu, you can choose the sources settings or any available timeline effects as the default timeline effects. For example, let's choose 2D Transform. When you return back to the sequence and go into any segment within the effects environment, the default timeline effects is now 2D Transform. Switching to any shot will default to 2D Transform. Even if you had been using a different timeline effects, like image for example, to perform a grade on a shot, as soon as you switch to another shot in the storyboard, the effects environment will automatically switch back to the default timeline effects, which you've guessed it, is 2D Transform. So you choose how the effects environment should behave, and at any time, you can go back to the Flame main preferences and change the default timeline effects to what you need. Now let's focus on the default setup of certain timeline effects. As you are probably already aware, when you enter the effects environment with either image, action, or the Gmask Tracer, the timeline effects is already set up in a certain way. Take the image timeline effects for example. If you switch to a 2-up view and look at the image schematic, you'll see that the default setup has a primary grade, one selective, and an output grade. All of these aspects are driven by the master grade shader. This is usually a great starting point for most situations. However, if you want to have more selectives and shaders as a starting point, you can customize the setup. Let's say that you want 3 selectives to start. Now you are also not limited by the type or by how many shaders you use. So select one of the master grade shaders and change it to the vignette shader. So every default setup should have vignetting on this selective. Next, go to the last selective and add a chromatic aberration shader to the pipeline. You can also dial in a default value if you want. So for every time you use the image timeline effects, this is the setup you'd like to start with. To save this setup as the default image timeline effects, go to the Setup menu, choose the Objects and Maps tab, and click Set Current as Default. Please remember that this saves the image pipeline and not the layout of the viewport or menus. You already have the option to customize your own layouts as a separate function. I'd also like to mention that any widgets or selectives you set in the main flame preferences are overruled by your custom default setup. Now, when you toggle to different shots in the sequence, the image timeline effects will always start with your custom default setup. You can even delete any old ones or reset the effects environment, and your new default will be loaded. The custom default is saved to your user profile. If you wish to go back to the original timeline effects setup that comes with Flame, just go back to the setup menu and click Revert to Factory. Confirm your choice, and the next time you load a new image timeline effects on a shot, it will be the same as before. Now, this also works in the Gmask Tracer and Action Timeline Effects. For example, let's add an Action Timeline Effects to this shot. Now, I know that some of you may never need the shadow or light in action. So if you don't want them, just delete the nodes and save this as the new default setup for the Action Timeline Effects. So now you have this great flexibility to set up your image, action, and Gmask Tracer timeline effects. Hopefully, this will speed up your workflow, and at any time, you can return back to the factory defaults if you want. Now, this whole video has focused on the timeline effects default settings for image, Gmask Tracer, and action. This all takes place in the effects environment. But it's also worth considering how the default settings work in batch and affect those specific nodes. Since the tools are shared between the environments, setting any custom defaults in the image or Gmask Tracer timeline effects will update the matching nodes in batch. This only affects any new nodes you create after setting the custom defaults. This is bidirectional, so updating the default settings in the image or Gmask Tracer node will update any new image or Gmask Tracer timeline effects. The only exception to the rule is action. This is down to what you can do with action in a flow graph versus action as a timeline effects. In any case, you can still set a custom default in the action node or timeline effects. However, their custom defaults are separated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel and click the bell to be notified for future videos. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. And thanks for watching.